us feel lost making these decisions. However, StudyCo has been immensely patient and supportive throughout this journey. The support and guidance provided by Ms. Mubaraka and the efforts she took to go above and beyond for my future gave me a sense of security and relief. Additionally, StudyCo has been accommodating and extremely understanding, and that is why I would strongly recommend StudyCo to anybody.
Hello, I am Jason Matthias, and I went to Indian School Muscat and graduated in the year 2017. I then approached StudyCo, specifically Ms. Annette Rosario, to gain help in pursuing my studies in the United Kingdom. It was a very smooth process from the beginning till the end. The list of required documents were given to me well in advance. The procedures were laid out very well, and the visa procedures were explained thoroughly. With the help of Ms. Annette and her persistent work towards my application, I was able to make my way into Solent University in Southampton, United Kingdom.
Hi everyone, my name is Rochelle Vaz, and I'm a former ISMite. After passing out from ISM in 2014 with flying colors, I really wanted to pursue MBBS to become a doctor, but I just didn't know where to begin. I came across StudyCo just by chance, and they provided me with excellent guidance, not just in understanding the gravity of medical education, but also showed me the right path to achieving my dreams. They guided me all through the application process for Monash University Malaysia, which is an Australian university in Malaysia, and took away a large part of my anxiousness in this regard.
Hello everyone, my name is Rupali and I am currently studying in Australia. So I always had this dream of going and studying abroad, and StudyCo has helped me immensely in achieving my dream. So I am here in Australia just because of them. They helped me in every step of the way, from filling in applications to arranging documents, filling in visa applications, everything. Even though the process was so complicated, they made it very easy. They do everything for you and they never get irritated, even if you ask them small questions again and again. So I encourage you all to go through StudyCo. They are wonderful people and I would recommend them to everyone. Thank you.
So, there are a few cool programs and services we offer at StudyCo that...
I'm Vishwanath Praveen, Assistant Head Boy of Indian School Muscat. It's an honor to have our prominent keynote speaker, popular for his unique English words, former Under Secretary General of the United Nations, recipient of Pravasi Bharatiya Samman, India's highest honor for overseas Indians, and renowned author, our chief guest, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Honorable Member of Parliament. We welcome and thank you, sir, for gracing this valedictory function of Avenir 2020.
I am Anjali Amnitan, Head Girl, Indian School Muscat. I find immense pleasure to welcome our and keynote speaker, author, former international civil servant, UN peacekeeper, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Honorable Member of Parliament, to the valedictory function, Avenir 2020. I find immense pleasure to welcome our Honorable Chief Guest and Keynote Speaker, author, former international civil servant and UN Peacekeeper, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Honorable Member of Parliament, to the valedictory function, Avenir 2020.
Distinguished guests, good afternoon, everyone. We are delighted to have you all with us today for Avenue 2020, a mission to enkindle the minds of those students in diversified fields and motivate them to choose the courses of their interest and caliber. I am Qazi Muhammad Ashaz Ali of Class 11A from Indian School, Muscat, and it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all this beautiful afternoon. I request the audience to fill the feedback form that will be posted in the description box towards the end of the session. Today, we are privileged to have with us an eminent personality from Syracuse University, New York, USA, who will discuss the courses available with them. Over to you, madam, for your presentation.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shirlin C. Chua, and I am the Syracuse University Regional Manager for Undergrad Admissions. I'm the person responsible when it comes to application reading of students applying from the Middle East, and that includes Oman. So if ever you decided to apply to Syracuse, I will be your direct contact. I'll be more than happy to guide you from the application process through easier transition to Syracuse. So for this afternoon, I will give you a quick overview about our university, our programs, application process, and then I have one of our alumnus from Oman who went to a high school in Indian school in Muscat to share about his student life on campus and talk about his life as an engineering student. So without further ado, let's get started. So Syracuse University is located in upstate New York. We are easy distance driving from big cities like New York City, Boston, Montreal, Toronto. We have great transportation access, so it's easy for you to go to this bigger city during weekend to unwind. We have our own international airport in the city of Syracuse, which is 15 minutes away from the campus. We also have our great train and bus transportation, and of course you can easily drive. Then at Syracuse, we have four seasons, so you'll get the chance to experience the fall, then comes the winter, spring, and the summer. So each season, they give different activities every month to help you to ease your transition in the city of Syracuse. And our city was named as the number one safest city for safe refuge from natural disaster, according to The Atlantic. Then our university was one of the very few universities in the US who were given permission to do face-to-face classes this fall. And at the same time, we also offer distance learning to those who cannot travel back on campus because of travel restrictions, or maybe they prefer to be studying from the comfort of their home. So this year is a very special year for us as Syracuse University turned 150 years old. So we are a university of many firsts. So we started the School of Information Studies in the United States. We were the first university to offer this School of Information Studies, which is until now the center of the research in the United States. We offered the very first visual and performing arts to offer Bachelor of Fine Arts in the United States. And we were one of the very first universities in the US to allow women to study, to give equality to women when it comes to education. As a matter of fact, the very first African American woman to become a doctor earned her degree from Syracuse University. So at Syracuse University, we do offer more than 200 majors and 100 minors to choose from. So each of our 9 individual colleges, they have different entry requirements. Some are more selective than the others. However, you can easily explore your options in Syracuse University as you can do double major. Sometimes students, they even do triple major, or maybe they explore minors across the discipline. And at Syracuse, we maintain small classes. We only have an average class size of 26 students per class to ensure the attention you need from the professors and for you to be able to express yourself. So the professors will know you by names, not by numbers. And even after you graduate from Syracuse University, you still have the connection. It's a personal relationship among your classmates and your professors. And we are very international. We have 20% international student body in Syracuse, which is higher than the other US universities. So we have students from 50 US states and 127 countries. So our 200 majors were divided into 9 individual colleges. So we have the College of Arts and Sciences. This is the biggest college that we have. It's a home for sciences and mathematics, humanities, and social sciences. It offers more than 50 majors, 40 minors, and it also offers the master's and PhD program. Then, of course, our School of Architecture. We are currently number 5 as best architecture in the United States. We're the 4th oldest architecture school in the United States as well. This is a 5-year degree program that will lead you to becoming an architect without the need of doing a master's degree. Then we have our School of Information Studies. Like I mentioned on my earlier part of my presentation, we're the original when it comes to information school. And again, it's highly ranked in the United States. So if you are students who would like to integrate technology, business, and communications, this is the right college for you. If you would like to work for companies such as LinkedIn, Facebook, Google, any kind of companies such that, then you can definitely try to consider School of Information Studies. Then our School of Education, currently we're number 2 in the United States as best special education, and currently number 5 as best colleges offering degree in education. It's a very highly ranked college in the US, and at the same time, it is a very small college that we have very, very few students per class. And then the job placement starts as early as first year, first semester. So you can start doing teaching placement even at the start of the fall in your first year. At this college, we have a very exciting partnership with SUNY Upstate, the medical school across the university. So we have 3+3 program. So you can do 3 years to do bachelor degree and health exercise science at Syracuse. Then automatically you will be entitled to continue your doctorate for physical therapy at SUNY Upstate. So in 6 years, you will be graduating with BSc Health and Exercise Science plus Doctoral of Physical Therapy. And of course, we have our Sport and Human Dynamics, which is currently number 4 in the United States as best human development and family studies. We're also currently number 11 in our social work. At this college, you'll see a variety of programs, which is, I think, very needed at this time. Like you can see public health, you can see nutrition science, dietetics, sports management, sports analytics. Again, the college is so small that you have a very small class, and there's an extensive field placement and internship opportunities. Then, of course, our College of Engineering and Computer Science, which is divided into mechanical and aerospace engineering, civil and environmental engineering, electrical engineering, computer science, and biomedical and chemical engineering. I will not be discussing a lot about this because, as I said earlier, we have an alumnus from Oman who went to school in Indian School of Muscat to talk about the College of Engineering. Then, of course, we have our Newhouse School of Public Communications. We're currently ranked number 3 as the best college to offer a degree in communications and journalism. We're number 1 when it comes to best college newspaper. And this is our school that started in 1934, so one of the oldest school of journalism in the United States. It is very highly ranked and very demanding program. Then we have our College of Visual and Performing Arts, which is divided into School of Art. We're currently number 3 as best schools for art majors. We also have the Communications and Rhetorical Studies. Then there's School of Design, where you can see highly ranked programs such as Industrial Interaction Design and Environmental Interior Design. Then we have our School of Drama, which is currently ranked number 8 and as the most represented colleges in the Broadway. Then our School of Music, currently ranked number 21 as top music schools. And then, of course, we have our Transmedia, which has the film program, currently ranked number 18 in the United States. Then, of course, we have our business school. We name it as Whitman School of Management, which is currently ranked number 23 as best undergrad business schools in the United States out of thousands and thousands of business schools in the country. So we have highly ranked majors such as entrepreneurial, currently ranked number 4. We have marketing, currently ranked number 17, and a lot of business majors that you can choose from. So each of our 9 individual colleges, they have different academic and career departments. So for example, you decided to apply to Syracuse University. Before you join us in campus in the fall, you already have your academic advisor reaching out to you in the summer. That means you already have your courses set even before you travel on campus. So let's say when you reach the campus, you discover your real passion and you would like to change your major. That's okay. That's why we have intra-university transfer, that is transferring from one college to another inside Syracuse University. So let's say you applied for engineering, then you decided you would like to do business instead. That's okay. With the help of your academic advisor, just let the advisor know of your future career goal, then hopefully you will still be able to graduate within 4-year program, even though you change major. And that's the advantage of US education in general. You can easily change your major because we understand you're still too young when you enter college and you might discover something that you didn't know exists. Then, aside from academic advising, each of our 9 individual colleges, we also have their own career department. So you'll see yourself attending our career fair every semester. We get companies not just from New York. We get companies from all over the states. They come to Syracuse. They recruit our students for internships. And then many of our students, even before they graduate, they already have multiple job offers because they love our students. They see how dedicated and passionate they are. So most of our students, they already have multiple job offers. And then we have our career department for the university as a whole that guide our students in choosing which among those companies will be the best option for them. So our university is a research one university. So if you're looking for research opportunities, look for a research one in the United States. We have a dedicated department on campus. It is called SOARS. It's an office for undergrad research and creativity engagement where you can become part of our research team as early as undergraduate. So you don't need to wait to be a master's degree or PhD. We have our undergraduate students part of the big research funded by the US government. And when we say research, it's not just about laboratories. It's not just about engineering. We have research in many fields, like we have research in business. So our students can start their business venture while studying. So many of our students, they already have their business set even before they graduate. We also have research in performance, in performing stage. So we have Syracuse stage where we ask our students to perform. So they just not perform inside the campus, they perform in Syracuse stage, which is one of the biggest stage in the United States. Then aside from our main campus in Syracuse, you have the opportunity to do study abroad. So you have 6 centers to choose from where you can spend 1 semester up to 1 academic year outside the US. So we have centers in London, we have in Italy, we have in Florence, we have in San Diego, we have in Hong Kong as well, and of course we have one in Spain. Then if you're looking for short study abroad opportunities in the summer, short courses, we have partnership with more than 60 countries where we offer 100 programs. Then for those of you who's considering to apply for the College of Engineering and Computer Science or to the College of Arts and Sciences, we have our Discovery Program. And for the Discovery Program, you have the opportunity to spend your first year, first semester in Spain or Italy or France before joining us for your first year, second semester in Syracuse. So that way you will not be too far from home. It's a little bit easier transition for you. So aside from the academic rigor that we do offer, we want to make sure you can balance your academic and social life. You can choose from 300 majors and student organizations. You can join any number of them. Of course, you should know how to balance your academic and social life. So these are just some of the activities that we are giving to our students, pictures of the orange after dark activities. So these are a group of activities after classes where you can do group skiing, you can watch a concert, you can watch premiere movie, you can do community service, you'll have free pickup and drop off in your residences. And this is a very brand new facilities on campus. We're very excited on this one. We just opened this year. So it's a place to go for physical and mental activities because we know how academic rigor our colleges are. We wanna make sure you have the place to relax. So if you want to do e-games, you want to do mountain climbing, play basketball, go to the gym, name it. It's a four-story building, which is all about physical and mental activities. Then this is our student center where our students hang out just to spend their free time together. It's currently under renovation. We're trying to give you a bigger space because of the social distancing. Then at Syracuse, it is mandatory for you to live on campus for the first 2 years of your studies. It is for your own convenience. It is for your own safety since you're new to the city, you're new to the community. And part of your residence plan will be your meal plan so that you don't need to worry what food to eat. We offer special dietary requirements. Just let us know in advance and we'll make sure you get the right food for you. So we offer halal, we do offer vegan, vegetarian, just let us know. And there's a couple of ways when it comes to choosing roommates. Of course, if you have a friend attending at the same time with you, you can choose each other, or you can do the random selection if you are the very, if you would like to become interesting, let's say, what kind of roommate will I have? Or you can join our college roommate. It's an online platform where you can write down your likes and dislikes until you meet your potential roommate. Or you can be part of our learning community. So learning community is the best way for you to live with the same group of students in the same floor, in the same building, with the same interests like yours. So that you know you'll get along very well to this group of students that you will see every day in your residences. So there's a lot of options to choose from when it comes to learning community. What you can see is just an example of our engineering and computer science learning community. That means all of the students living in that floor, in that residences, all study engineering and computer science. Or you can also do learning communities like if you're into cultural or politics or business, community service, name it. We have an options on our website. You'll see the drop-down menu. Then when you graduate, you'll join a 250,000 of alumni that spans the globe. We have alumni in 178 countries and 50 US states. So wherever you go, I'm pretty sure you'll see your network from Syracuse University. As you can see on the picture, the current US elected president in the United States, Joe Biden, he graduated from Syracuse University. And we're so excited that we have the very first US elected alumnus of Syracuse University. Then in the Middle East itself, we have more than 1,000 of alumni who hail from the Middle East. So let's say if you would like to go back home, then definitely just reach out to our career department and they will introduce you to the alumni from the Middle East. We have accomplished alumni in the Middle East, such as the CEO of GE, Nabil Habayeb, Joe Anais. They're both from Syracuse University in Saudi, the very first Arab astronaut to reach the space, that's His Highness Prince Sultan bin Salman. He graduated from Syracuse University. One of the very popular Arab personality, Prince Al-Walid, he's also from Syracuse University. Then our application process, we are through common application. So we have early decision. The early decision deadline was done last November 15, but we just announced having early decision too. The early decision to deadline is on January 1st, which has the same deadline with our regular decision, similar to January 1st. So early decision, this is the binding. So if you apply for early decision, you got admitted on your first choice, then you need to commit to that university. But let's say, for example, you applied for early decision for architecture, but you got admitted to an art program. That is not binding at all. So it will be only binding if you are admitted to your first choice. Then regular decision, of course, you can apply to any number of regular decision or probably check with your school counselor because usually the schools, they have limits when it comes to number of universities that you could apply. Then we do require two academic recommendation letters from two of your teachers. And we would like to see recommendation letters from the teachers that is somehow connected to the program that you are applying. So for example, you're applying for engineering. We are expecting to see recommendation letters from your teachers in physics, teachers in mathematics. Or if you're applying for let's say social sciences, we're expecting to see recommendation letter from your teacher, let's say in any social science subject at your school, or maybe school from teacher from your English subject as well. So aside from the two academic recommendation letters, we require one consular recommendation letter as well for us to know how do you deal with your fellow fellow schoolmates, not just classmates, the wider part of the community. Because for the teacher recommendation letter, we are expecting to see how you perform in the class. But from the school counselor, we would like to see how you perform in the whole school. Like, how do you communicate with your schoolmates? How are you when it comes to community service with the clubs and organizations? And like you already know, application in the US is holistic. So it's not just about the grades. Of course, we love to see good grades. But aside from the grades, we want to make sure that you are fitted to our university. So we will be looking at your essay. We will be reading your recommendation letters. We will be reading your extracurricular activities. So extracurricular activities are very important when it comes to application in the US. So let's say you're applying for business. We would like to see that you're active in your clubs that can show your leadership skills, like becoming part of the business club or maybe becoming a leader of a certain club. That way you can demonstrate to us that you have the capacity of becoming a leader. Then an interview. So for Syracuse, it is not mandatory, but I strongly recommend students to do interview because it's an opportunity for us to know more about you, to get information that we will not be able to see on your common application that will help us making decision when we start reading your application. And at the same time, it's a way for you to demonstrate your real interest to the university. So if you're highly considering a certain university in the US, I would recommend reach out to the admissions officer and then request for an interview session. So I offer interview session to students applying from the Middle East. I normally request through email and then we will set a date and time that will work for both of us. Then when it comes to tests, we are test optional. That means we do not need SAT, we do not need ACT. We admit students without those tests. We do not penalize students for not taking SAT or ACT, not only for this year, but we've been optional for many years now. Sometimes we might be asking for IELTS or TOEFL if English is not your first language, but that can be a case-to-case basis. All you need to do is to communicate with us. And again, another way to demonstrate your English proficiency aside from your essay is the interview session. Then, at Syracuse University, we do offer merit scholarships. So for the merit scholarships, you do not need to apply. All you need to do is to submit your application to Syracuse University. And as an international student, you will be automatically considered for merit evaluation. Now, if you're one of the best students applying in the application pool, when you get your admission letter, it will mention the amount of scholarships awarded. So the amount varies. It can be up to full tuition. Yes, we do offer full tuition waiver to the best student who can demonstrate academic and personal achievements. Though that is very limited, but we do offer. And the good thing is, whatever amount you received on your first year, it will be automatically renewed on the next year and next throughout your education in Syracuse. You don't need to reapply. All you need to do is to maintain the grades required by your college. Now, if you are not happy with the amount of scholarships, but if Syracuse is your top choice, just communicate with me and I will see what I can do for you. We want to make sure that we are offering the right amount to the right candidate. But if you are a US citizen, regardless if you've been in the United States or not, then aside from the merit scholarships, we also offer need-based. For the need-based, there will be the CSS and the FAFSA profile that you need to fill out and certain deadlines are applicable. Okay, so that's a quick overview of our university. Now, may I request Manu, if he is with us, to please talk about the School of Engineering. So I'll be sharing the screen for you. Just let me know whenever you would like me to go next.
Sure, yeah, you can go ahead. You can just go on the screen now.
Correct.
Sherlyn, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, can you go on full screen? I'm not sure if I can.
Not sure. Okay, hold on a second. Let me share once again. to the full screen?
I think it's that little button above the plus on the right side.
I think that should be fit. Go ahead.
Okay. So I'll just start. But thank you, Sheldon. And this is a little about Syracuse University and my experience of having been there for about 8 years before I moved to London. So a little bit about SU. It was founded in 1870, and like Sheldon mentioned, this is the 150th year. It is one of the top 100 universities among the national universities in the US. And a fun fact, like again, Sheldon mentioned that the US president-elect, Joe Biden, graduated from the Syracuse University Law School as well. And moving on, I just want to talk a little bit about the student life. So when I was admitted for the first time back in 2013, I was put into Day Hall, and that is the picture on the right side, the building on the right side, that is Day Hall. It is compulsory in the first and second year to be in campus housing, and I ended up with one of the most amazing person, I would say, and because we still are really good friends. It was gradual. We took some time to build that friendship, and today I think we're stronger than ever because we did go through a lot, being two students who just didn't know anything, and then getting to know a whole different life altogether. It was nice, the least to say. In terms of cafeterias and food around campus, there's over 8 cafeterias in and around campus. There's a stellar Greek life, and there's over 70 to 80 student-led clubs. That's a side of the organizations that are on campus. There is also an entire street full of restaurants, literally 3 minutes away from the university, which is even better because if you do get tired of eating the food on campus, you can always go with your friends, and we call it Marshall Street. Just go to Marshall Street, and there's like a plethora of restaurants of different cuisines to choose from. And if that's still not enough, there's just a 10-minute bus or a cab right away is Syracuse downtown, which is again filled with a plethora of restaurants and cafes. And it's really cute because it's not like a big city, but it's also like a small town. Now diving a little deeper into student clubs as such, my experience at least with them, for about 5 years, I was the president of the South Asian Students Association. Essentially what we used to do is we would organize every sort of South Asian culture themed event. And this was mostly to do with the Indian kind of events because we would host Holi, we would host Diwali, we would host Garba. We would also sometimes even host Christmas, but that was depending upon if students were there or if we could do it earlier, depending upon the time available. It was fun because we had over 200 members of a student body, and this was mostly Indian and South Asian students, like Bangladeshi students or Pakistani students. It was just all together as one. There was never a distinction between, oh, this is they're all different. We were all just like one big student body. Following that, I was also a chairperson for the new RSO review board. This is basically like an organization where you review the new student organizations joining the campus. And again, I was also the vice president of the student association for the academics part. This is my experience with the student clubs, but there's also something for everyone who decides to want to be in a club. And I would strongly recommend, no matter which university you choose to go to, it is important that you actually get in and be part of a club, because it does expand your horizon to know and meet new people and understand what you actually want out of being in the university, to also show your leadership and teamwork skills. Now, moving on forward towards the College of Engineering, this is where I graduated from. I got a master's and I got a bachelor's from the university. It has a lot of options, as Sheldon mentioned, and ranges from aerospace to mechanical to civil, environmental, biomedical, and the list just keeps going on. But one of the main things that attracted me to this university was the fact that this is one of the only universities with a flight simulator on campus. And to my degree that I graduated from, which was aerospace engineering, this really, really, really helped. And aside of that, I was also a teaching assistant for the course that involved flight simulator. all courses are ABET accredited, and this is something that most companies, when they hire you as an engineer, they make sure that your courses are ABET accredited. Also, if you decide to go for a master's elsewhere, this is something that the universities look for. And aside of that, one of the most important things you want to be involved in as an engineer is research. And Syracuse University has a huge number of research opportunities available. And it can range from NASA to the US Air Force, the carrier, to Hyundai. And basically, I think they really like Syracuse students for who they are. And that's kind of why we still have a lot of engineering research options available. Moving on to my experience with the university, I graduated with a bachelor's and a master's in aerospace engineering. I was also a teaching assistant for 2 years, and I taught over four courses over the course of 2 years. I was, like I've mentioned earlier, in terms of research, and Shirley mentioned as well, from my undergraduate time, I was involved in research with advanced computational methods. It was Mr. Dannenhofer, who was the professor at the time. And this was a research commissioned by NASA and the US Air Force. And this not only helped me understand the material better, but it also got me in touch with some of the top officials in these companies. And it also kind of brought out my leadership skills in order to understand and know more about myself, to be honest. And ultimately, I did a TNA work placement at Lockheed Martin post-graduation, which was Syracuse, but I decided to not go ahead with it because I wanted to pursue a second master's degree, and that's when I moved back to London. And moving forward, this is a little snippet of my graduation from Syracuse University, and I would like to thank you all for your attention. And I would like to also open up the podium for any questions you may have. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Manu. That is very helpful. So if you have any questions, Manu and I will be more than happy to answer them.
Thank you, sir and ma'am. That was quite an impressive and informative presentation. We will now be moving on the queries from our audience. The first is, what is the required SAT score for the admission?
Okay, so like I mentioned on my earlier presentation, we do not really require SAT for you to be able to apply to Syracuse University. But if for whatever reason you've taken the test, maybe it is required by the other US institutions that you are applying, then each of our 9 individual colleges, they have different entry requirements. So if you are considering, let's say, engineering, College of Engineering, we would like to see an SAT math score of at least 600. And if 650, the better. Then for the English, at least 600. If you're applying for journalism, we would like to see SAT English of 650, for the math 600, and the list goes on. So it really depends on the program. But again, it is optional.
Thank you. How many years courses does minor and major refer?
I'm sorry, can you say it again?
How many years courses does minor and major refer?
Minors, it's like when you declare a certain major, you can choose any number of minors and it doesn't affect the number of years, your duration at Syracuse University. So you can still finish your program, let's say in 4 or 5 years, depending on your program, even though you declare 1, 2, or 3 minors. So those are just additional. They will not add to the number of semesters.
Okay. Is archaeology courses available?
It is, as a bachelor degree. You can do either BSc or BA. You have the options to do that.
Okay. Journalism, is it available at after 12th? Do you also deal with print media?
I didn't get it. Journalism, it's about?
Is it available at after 12th grade? And do you also deal with print media?
Yes, so at Syracuse University, you will be eligible to enter directly to freshmen after completing 12 years of studies. So let's say after finishing your high school from an Indian curriculum, which is equivalent to 12 years, you will be eligible directly to first year entry. And that applies to all the program that we have, and that includes School of Journalism.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Next question we have is, could you explain about the fee structure?
Our tuition for this year is $50,000 per year. Then on top of that will be a cost of living of about $15,000, and that includes the residences and the meal plan. But I know it's a little bit expensive. That's the reason why we're offering merit scholarships to our students. And the good thing is we really would like to get students from the Middle East. And when we say Middle East, it's not about the nationality, it's from the last school attended. So I'm the person responsible in recruiting students from the Middle East. I do have a specific budget just to give the students applying from the Middle East. Again, it is based on the last school attended, and that includes students applying from Oman. Like I said, we do offer as much as full tuition, sometimes 50% less or $20,000 per year, and that will be consistent throughout your education at Syracuse. You just need to maintain certain grades. I think you're muted, sorry.
Sorry, could you elaborate on bioengineering and biotechnology?
Manu, do you want to talk about that since you're an engineering alum?
Yeah, sure. In terms of bioengineering, so there's again, you have the option of pursuing either bachelor's, a master's, or even to go up to a PhD. And with biomedical, in fact, over the course of me being there, the department has actually grown from being one of the nascent ones to a very well-established one. They do have some good research coming in. They did get some good grants while I was there. So I would say that they do have a vibrant biomedical and bioengineering department.
Okay, thank you, sir. Now on the final question for this session, what can you tell us about the medical area in SET?
Can you say it again, sorry?
Can you tell us more about the medical courses available?
Oh, we do not have the medical, the medicine proper at Syracuse. We do have pre-med program, that's a pre-health program. Because in the United States, you need to do the pre-health before entering to the medical school. So you will do the first four-year degree with us, and then you'll jump to medical school. That's why you will be getting this pre-health advisory career advisors to help you and guide you when it comes to preparation to medical school. But we have a good news. We just currently signed a partnership with SUNY Upstate and two other medical schools in the U.S., where, let's say, for example, you decided to do that partnership with SUNY Upstate and you're planning to do biology as your pre-health. So you'll do 3 years of biology with Syracuse University. If you meet the grades, then you will be automatically guaranteed for an admission to medical school of SUNY Upstate for another 4 years. So in just 7 years, you'll have a medical degree. Now, if you would like to do something else aside from biology, let's say you would like to do biomedical engineering or maybe biotechnology, then that will be 4+4. So 4 year degree of pre-med with us, then automatically guaranteed for admission to the medical school of SUNY Upstate, so 4+4. As you may already know, it's not easy to get into medical school in the United States, a very, very less percentage. So with this partnership, we're really excited about that. But the disadvantage is it is binding. So if you do that, you will be binded to do medicine to the SUNY Upstate. But aside from that, we still have another two more partnerships which are not binding at all. So with the help of our pre-health program, I think it is very important for you. If you would like to do medicine as your ultimate career goal, then just make sure enter a university in the United States that they have a great pre-health advisory members.
Thank you, madam, for the informative presentation and clearing all the doubts raised. As we come to the end of a wonderful session, I would like to express a gratitude to each and everyone behind the grand success of this session. First and foremost, I express a profound gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his great vision, leadership, and benevolence. May the Almighty bless His Majesty and this beautiful nation with peace and prosperity. On behalf of Indian School Muscat, the organizing team, and the entire audience, I extend a very hearty thanks to our speaker. We sincerely appreciate the time and efforts you took to share with us the courses you offer at Syracuse University, New York, USA. Wholeheartedly, I thank the chairman, Dr. Baby Sam Samuel, and members of Board of Directors, Indian Schools and Sultanate of Oman, Mr. Ajay Kumar Pillai, President and members of the Indian School Muscat Management Committee, Honorable Principal, Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan, presidents and members of all Indian school management committees in the Sultanate of Oman, principals, vice principals, assistant vice principals, supervisors, coordinators, head of departments, and teachers for the support and guidance for organizing such an event. Thank you all for encouraging all of us. I thank all the students and parents for being with us today and for your active participation during the entire program. Thank you, Indian School Muscat team, for Avenue 2020. Signing off now is Qazi Muhammad Ashaz Ali of Class 11A, Indian School Muscat. See you at the valedictory function of Avenue 2020 that begins at 4:30 p.m. Oman time. Join us there and know how we made it to this day of Avenue 2020. Thank you once again. Wishing you all success in your future endeavors.
Thank you.